Okay, you want to know everything about crawling. That's cool, but seems hardly possible in 10 minutes. However, let's give it a try, so fasten your seatbelts. Only humans crawl. If you mean by crawling self-propelled locomotion on hands and knees with the stomach off the floor. In developmental books, this is called creeping. The average child starts creeping at 10 months of age. Some creep several months earlier, others months later. But that's not to say that early creepers are also early walkers. You never can tell. The very first motion picture of a creeping child was made by Muybridge in 1885. Project photographs of a creeping child in a row, and what you see is movement. Incredible, don't you think? Yes, indeed, some children attain Olympic levels in creeping. Here you see some all-out efforts. The average creeping speed of a baby is about 2 kilometers per hour with an average distance per day of 200 meters. All these experienced kids show the so-called diagonal or cross pattern creep. Left hand, right knee, right hand and left knee, like the locomotion pattern of a lizard. It is said that there are also children with a salamander-like creeping pattern. Left knee, left hand, followed by right knee and right hand, but I did not run across them. Some believe that creeping is simply the consequence of maturation of the brain, but this boy seems to counter this hypothesis. He has very little brain volume, the colored parts in his MRI scan, but still can creep, walk and many more. His neurologist goes to the other opposite. He believes that training of creeping behaviors will develop the boy's brain. But that seems to me a far too optimistic idea. Anyway, children have to exercise a lot before they can creep. After these tiring exercises, some babies develop certain transitional creeping techniques. This is a very special one. The girl uses only her hands to move forwards. Not very handy, it seems, and only possible on a smooth surface. Other kids also mainly use their arms and drag their knees under their stomach. An occasionally seen variant is the side leg creeping, sometimes called the crab crawl. But the crab moves sideways and babies don't. Side leg creeping babies use one foot to produce some extra propulsion. They invented this technique by themselves, nobody taught them to do that, and brain maturation seems also not a plausible explanation. And the technique cannot be found in any developmental book. Interesting. Creeping backward is difficult. On smooth surfaces, you can slide backwards. But you must be an experienced creeper to execute this properly. Most of these kids can already walk. Amazing is this boy. He creeps backwards on command of his father.
Backwards.
Further, it was for me a big surprise to find babies who creep on their elbows and knees. Of course, we must not forget that the majority of creeping babies first practiced another movement pattern, namely crawling, the self-propelled locomotion by means of the limbs with the stomach sliding over the floor, also called the marine or army crawl. Many experienced crawlers use both arms alternatively to move forward. Yes, like the marines. But again, things are always difficult at the start. Only pushing with your feet produces little progression. The crawling pattern becomes more and more coordinated. Sometimes mainly one arm is used. An often seen crawling technique consists of the simultaneous use of both arms. Related to this technique is push-up crawling. Understandably, in particular on rugged surfaces, this technique is applied. Now the stomach gets off the floor. But the exception proves the rule. This is cheerio, not yet crawling. Here, on the carpet, she shows a mixed crawling pattern. However, on the parquet, she uses the push-up technique. Apparently, she employs different movement patterns on different surfaces. A nice example of adaptive motor behavior. In about a month, she seems to have acquired the diagonal creeping pattern. And then there are babies who can crawl on their back. Wow! As you can see, my time is running out, so more about crawling in part 2, hopefully coming soon in this global theater.